I saw the pepper.
It's a ghost pepper.
Okay.
Why are you laughing? Well, I don't know
about it.
You want to do it first?
Make sure you wash your hands after you touch it.
Just a little bit ever sure.
That's big. That's big, Wayne. Mm. Gotta stay in here, Shan. Wait before you bite it, Ring. Let me get Shan.
I mean,
all right.
Best pepper ever.
<That's sick. laughs> Wait, don't eat it yet. We still get Shan reaction. Is it hot? 1 through 10.
10. My eyes. Oh, I'm dying.
Oh. Oh my gosh. Is that hot? Okay, Ray. No time.
This would be easy peasy.
Okay. No, I can't eat no fried red. Oh, you ain't supposed to do that. You supposed to just eat the pepper.
Yeah. It doesn't hurt. You should go get Shan. She'll act like she's about to die.
Yeah, right. Okay. Well, how big was your piece? Was it big?
It's big. What's over here?
We'll take another bite then.
Why?
That'll be an after thing. After you bite it, it'll be an after bite. Like, it start burning afterwards. No.
Well, it burns, but it's not bad. Then the first two times.
Yeah, they done did it before. Look. 1 through 10, how hot it is.
I like a 6.
A 6? She said a 6. Oh my gosh! Oh. You threw the other part away. Do the coloring contest. We've been waiting on you.
What? They mix. Is this like
Ripple Snatch or? Here, here, here. I got them getting y'all cam. Y'all want to have your pants twisted. You don't want to do it? You got to turn them over and pick. Turn them all over. It can't be no tie, sweetie.
I've decided it can be. It's all of them look nice. I can't choose
one. You can't choose?
Mm-mm. All of them look good. I like all of them.
You do? Mm-hmm. Oh, that's sweet.
They all stand out the same to me.
Oh, okay. Well, I guess it's a tie. Well, everybody,
I'm looking like y'all calling some, a dog, a goat, a bear, a clown, or something. How you gonna design?
It's hard to pick on these type of stuff.
Yeah, ain't like you got some animals or something running around.
Yeah.
A monkey or something. Or some clowns.
Some so trees it, it's a three-way tie
yeah.
or a two-way tie?
I said three. Like all of them. I said all of them stand out on me.
Which one's
no matter which way I put it, it still stays the same.
Oh, okay.
Don't touch nothing.
Oh!
Got a broke trigger finger. Mm-hmm. Baby. I can't just say, hey, this one looks good, that one looks good. I can't just say,
everybody done got better, huh? Since the last time you did this. Because you can't even choose.
It comes with aging.
Yeah, that's what I told them. They get better when they get older. I guess it's a three-way tie, y'all.
You keep lying, Sharon, you're going to get better at it.
Mm-hmm.
Be like Gina. Gemma. Well, that all look good.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Who's this who?
I like all of them. I like the exact same thing.
Yeah, it's the same thing. We just...
Let's hang out somewhere, get some old school coloring books.
We got old school coloring books, like you used to do.
Yeah.
Disney. Yeah. This is what we wanted to do today, the different one. From the Colorama book.
House or something. Dog.
So you done? Yeah. I guess he done, man. Do you want to know who's this who? Can you guess who's this who's though?
Nope.
For real? Mm-hmm. You can't guess who's this who's?
This one Rena's.
Yep. That one Rena's.
This one Sharon's.
Nope.
What?
Nope.
This one Sharon.
Yep.
This one yours?
Yep.
Y'all
get
good.
Y'all mad.
That's good.
Yeah. How you know that was Rena? Yes.
This just seemed like that's my Rena.
That's Rena. And you thought this was Shane's?
Yeah.
And that was mad.
Sharon seemed pinky. Serena seemed bluish.
Yeah. Yeah, you would think that. Okay. So it's a three-way tie. Wow. I used to put them on the refrigerator.
Personally, I think I would have won, you know.
Oh, but they all good. We all said that, though. Mm-hmm. All of them look good, though. And that I saw that, too. Y'all getting good, but that's kind of like Maz didn't pop though. Man, I should have won. Nah, I didn't think I was gonna. Yeah, I think it is too. I'm just, well, I taught them well. okay, so.
They can't tell me hammer time, hey, hammer time. They can't tell me hammer time, hey, bedtime. I ain't never had a bedtime. Headline, boy, you looking at a headline. Hammer time. They can't tell me hammer time, hey, hammer time. Hey, they can't tell me hammer time. Bedtime, why me kill the same bedtime.
Hey, peeps. How y'all doing today?
Y'all doing good? That's good. Hi, I'm doing good. Y'all. Really? That's how I'm doing. Really? But anyways, yeah, I'm sitting on the floor. My pillow keep falling. I had to open my curtain a little bit to get a little sunlight. Really? See? That's how I'm doing. Like, I'm having really moments. But that pillow gonna sit right there. But today is June 19th, Wednesday at 1... No. Really? Just count the many times I'm gonna say really throughout the video. June 19th, Wednesday at 12:55 in the p.m. Almost 1 o'clock. Not quite there yet, but we almost there. So, today, what have I been doing today? I got up almost around 9 o'clock. We had to do our other coloring page today, so we just finished that. I finished mass around 12:30. I started around 9:20. So yeah, really about like 3 hours it took me to color that paper, like yesterday. But I got some footage of the one we did yesterday with the hubby being the judge. He couldn't pick no baddies because he said all of them looked good. And that was like a little different because normally we do like clothing or a person or an animal, like from my Disney book. Well, yeah, my Cinderella. It got all the little princesses in it. And so we normally do coloring for those type, from that coloring book. But this time we did from my Colorama book. And he was like, all of them looked good. So therefore, Shan got $2 and Ring got $2. So today we did it again. Since tomorrow our last day of school, I told him, you gotta pick. Come on in. I can't be passing out two here and two there. No, it's supposed to be a winner. You know, so when he wake up, we'll have Shan just finished like about 5 minutes ago. Probably not even quite that long ago. But maybe yeah. And so when he wake up, he gonna judge it, and that'll be that. And tomorrow, Thursday, our last day, I did their report cards and everything, and so I pass them out tomorrow, because they actually get grades. I grade their work and everything, and report card. I do transcripts for college, just in case they want to go or whatever. And high school diplomas, I order them offline just in case they have to show it. But they're going to school or something. But so I have everything squared away for when they finish high school, they can make their next transition. And so, yeah, I got that done. And I'm thinking about going to Six Flags. I'm thinking about going Friday. The reason due is the weather looked decent Friday. No really rain. It's supposed to be close to the 80s. So I'm going to run it by the hubby and see what he say. Because we're supposed to go Saturday. But nobody really doing nothing anyway. So we through with school tomorrow. Go to bed early Thursday night. Wake up Saturday and hit the street. Come back and we're done. And then maybe Saturday we could go see Anna, because I want to see Anna. So yeah, that'd probably be our weekend. We'll see. I got to run about a hubby first, because he was expecting, because it's like 50% chance of rain, but it's going to be like 83. I just don't want to be out there in the rain. And I don't know, 83s be like 90s and 95s, y'all. I mean, if it wasn't going to be raining, 50% of rain, I still go and everything, but I'm just not trying to be out there in the rain like that. You can't really enjoy yourself like that. So Friday looked like a really good day, and I don't want to do it on Sunday. It's rain on Sunday too, like 20%, 30, 40% of rain on a Sunday. But the hubby had to go back to work like Sunday night. So yeah, that's the plans. And what else? Yesterday I fixed some Italian beef with some sweet potato fries, and it was really good. And the Italian beef it's in a container at Walmart by Papa Charlie's. And I put that container of beef with the mixture and stuff all in it in a crock pot and let it cook like 4 hours on low. And then because they be kind of big pieces, I just shredded them up into smaller pieces and bought the French roll bread and everything. So that was really good because I haven't had none of that in a minute. And today I'm fixing chicken tacos, and I might air fry the hubby some wings. But I'm kind of tired. My ass hurt, y'all. Look at it. Just staring. My fingers all cramped up for holding a coloring pencil yesterday, today, Monday we did. I did 8 word searches, so I done been putting the strain on my eyeballs and my hands. So, I mean, that done kind of wore me out already. I'm like, and I got to cook. Oh my gosh, and make a video. And we ain't even talking about squeezing my little workout up in there because I got on my bike. I be getting on my bike and at night I do different things and stuff. I just try to be creative. I got bands and stuff, so I kind of do that around 9 o'clock-ish. Yeah, my little squats and bands and stuff. Yeah, I normally do them every night, but last night I didn't do it. I was just too tired. I was just extremely tired because I had a lot to do yesterday. And that's probably how, and this is kind of how I feel today. I did a lot of cooking yesterday. I just did a lot. And I washed yesterday. Oh my gosh. So yeah. I thank God for sleep because my strength is kind of sort of renewed to get her done today, but I don't know how I'm gonna be feeling this evening and later on tonight. So yeah, I might capture the hubby gray and our other coloring paper and let y'all see that. I don't know. Y'all might miss that. Cause today is my last video until September. This is it, people. So yeah. I'm just tired all the way around, man, body and soul. I am tired. I really need to regroup, for real. Especially get ready for this next school year. I gotta get their classes together. I gotta buy books for their classes. So yeah, she ain't gonna be a senior. So. And I do class rings, I buy cap and a gown, I do pictures, I go to the mall and get senior pictures taken with the cap and gown I buy with the tassels that goes on to say 2020. So I kind of, get them that type of experience, even though it's homeschooled, I still try to, give them that experience that I kind of sort of had when I graduated from grammar school and high school. I didn't get my class ring though, cause me and my brother was graduating at the same time. He was graduating out of 8th grade. I was graduating out of high school. She had to do him and me. I was like, nah, ma, that's okay. I'm like, I could always get that when I get on my own and get money. I could buy it on my own. I ain't never bought it. I don't even really wear rings like that. Maybe fashionable rings every now and again, but nah, not like that. So yeah, I guess I done caught y'all up. So let me get into this read. I hope y'all been enjoying these reads, especially the basic concepts. What kind of hurts are we talking about? This have really, really been a good paper even for me, y'all, because I be sitting back just, I turn the camera off, I sit back and think on this stuff. I was like, wow. Because like I said, we all get things, And reading this paper, some things that came up even with myself that I'd be like, oh, I have to deal with that. That's an issue. And so, yeah, and I've been talking to the hubby about it and everything, So we all in this boat together. And we all going to get our healing together. Whatever God bring to the forefront, deal with it, no matter how bad it hurts. it's okay. That's why I had to tell myself, it's okay, Sharon, it's okay. Yeah, y'all, so let us, I was going to try to read this book, but no, I'm just say this book for when I get back. I mean, chapter 5, and again, I don't even know how many chapters it is in this book. It's 12 chapters. I'm going to try my best to finish this book by the end of this year. That's my goal. I got so many goals, y'all, I'm setting for myself. I'm on a goal roll. But anyways, this is going to be... This is going... Well, it ain't that short. So let me get into it. And yeah, hump day, y'all. Got to tell you, hump day, yes. I'm laughing. Thursday is the day for me. I'm like, woo! School over, yes! Anyway, let's get into this. And we're talking about pain and depression. Okay? Here we go. For severe or persistent depression, try standing behind the prayer subject. Lay hands on the prayer on the subject's head and pray in the spirit. That just brought another memory to the forefront. When I used to go to church all the time, my auntie, you know, she was an evangelist, right? And she used to do them prayer calls. You know, you come up for prayer. And my grandmama and them in their church, they used to do it too. They would put their hands, put some oil, olive oil on your forehead, put their hands on you, and just start praying. And I don't know what it was about, the prayer, but I really think it was a God thing, because most of the time, majority of the time, when they lay hands on me and start praying for me, it's like the prayer was specifically for me. And I don't know why, I used to always just start crying and like, oh, just never like raise your hands up and just get your man on the Lord and all that, and just tell Jesus thank you and stuff. And I'd be like, thank you, Jesus. And then when they get start to praying and just speaking into my life, right, I'd be like, oh, thank you, Jesus, thank you, Jesus. And you know, I'm a teenager, right? I'm like, oh, I'm sorry, Jesus, I'm sorry, you know, because, you know, growing up in church, like, God see everything you do, right? I'm like, oh, forgive me, Jesus, I'm so sorry. Ugly cry, for real. So I done experienced that a lot of times. I mean, I needed to stay in church and needed all them prayers over my life while I was in grammar school, going into high school and everything, because it was a whole struggle. So yeah, it say for severe persistent depression, I probably was depressed. Try standing behind a prayer subject, lay hands on the subject's head, and pray in the spirit. They prayed out loud, though. Agnes Sanford used this technique and found it effective. I have done this many times now and seen for myself how effective this can be. I used to pray on my kids like that, too. Especially my old ones, man. I was praying on them, laying hands on them, had them on their knees praying. I put blessed oil on their pillows, their shoes, whatever. I'm like, oh, Jesus. I had to go in like that. So, yeah. For those in severe depression, no words can comfort. And the typical spoken prayer, as opposed to praying quietly in the spirit, usually doesn't work. Severely depressed people often feel as if they are in a deep pit or well, or in utter darkness. And words, even if well meant, can add to the person's suffering. Give time for God to lead them out of the darkness into the light. And that is so true. Because that's how I do for my older kids. I'm not like little, like physically laying hands on them, but I pray in the spirit for them all the time, because if I was in their face and verbally praying for them, and the things I be praying for, they probably would catch feelings. You know, like, I don't need prayer for that. I ain't nothing wrong with that. I ain't that bad. No. Yeah. Big nut on. Okay. Depression often follows prolonged repression of anger, and anger that follows some hurt or series of hurts, which is what we are trying to help the prayer subject receive healing for. The purpose of the prayer is to and for all prayer, you know, whether, you know, like people in the hospital or just sick or lost a child or a loved one or whatever, the most times we get really deep into our prayer is for someone that is hurting, lost a job that hurts, you know, any kind of little loss or something, it hurts. And yeah, you want to like pray about that. And if it's like on a depression level and you're praying for a person that depressed, you want to pray that they come out of that darkness into the light, and God start the process. Just start the process, Father. So yeah. Depression may also accompany anxiety and fear, bitterness and resentment, and unforgiveness. Y'all know about that unforgiveness because I done been there too. But I learned. I let it go. Because unforgiveness is like what somebody might do to you that don't hurt you. And ain't no telling how deep it went. And you catch feelings. And sometimes you catch feelings for years. Unforgiveness could have you not speaking to a person for years. And even though you still, and it could cause that, it could start you on that path, but even if you ain't speaking to a person, you could still learn how to forgive that person. That don't mean you're going to start back speaking to that person after, you know, you really forgive them in your heart and everything for what happened or things said or whatever the situation may be. Because you can actually forgive people without having to break bread with them. You know what I'm saying? Or even be in their presence. Because forgiveness is for you. It's for you to live your best life. It's for you to be able to think, feel, and be like, I'm good about this situation now. I'm okay. You know, and that's what it's all about. And that's where, you know, you healed in that situation. So yeah, sometimes those feelings are subconscious but evident in a prayer subject's behavior, words, or tones of voice. And that is so true. Sometimes those feelings are subconscious, resentment, bitterness, fear, anxiety, and unforgiveness, but evident in a prayer subject's behavior, words, or tone of voice. Because y'all know when we got a problem with somebody, we will treat them a certain type of way. We will have a certain type of tone with them when we just agitated with them for the things they did and said over the years. You be like, you just snap, just attitudinal. You know what I'm saying? And we need to be healed from that. Whatever triggered all that to start down there, we need healing in that area. So we won't be living our life, because really the attitude, you ain't hurting that person for real, because really they don't even care. You know, you're hurting yourself and the people around you. You know, they can't enjoy you. They can't feel the love that you have down on the inside of you, all that love that is down there. They not experiencing that love. They not feeling that love because of, you know, all that issues we have and attitude we have and anger we have and, you know, how we talk and, you know, just always snappy, just always attitudinal, you know. It's serious. That's why I say it affects, hurts, wounds, and pains affects a lot of part of our daily life. So, let's keep it moving. Unfortunately, we have learned that some people have suppressed their memory or a series of memories so thoroughly that they cannot remember incidents that contributed to feeling depressed. Wow. Me, I always remember the feelings. I always remember the memories that have me feeling a certain type of way. For the most part. I can always go back to where masks came from, you know. But for those that can't, that's another place. To pray over somebody, like, Lord, bring it up. Bring all what need to come with that all the way up. Bring, they need to remember it. They need to feel it. So they can start working on it. So they can start getting healing on it. And so they can learn how to let it go and be healed. So they can really live their life and enjoy their life. And not just be, like, just sad. Just like she's, like this paper saying, like, outer darkness, like, whatever, just in utter darkness. I was almost there, I almost slipped there, you know. I was like, oh, it's real dark right there, but I'm like, I don't want to be there, Lord. I just don't want to be there. I need help. And that's what I actually said. I'm like, I need help, help me. I'm stuck, you know, and that was my prayer. It was short, but it was straight to the point. Okay, fortunately we have also learned that God heals despite that, and it's just despite of the series of memories so thoroughly that they can't remember incidents that contributed to feeling depressed. And God can still heal that, even if they don't remember. But the prayer is to remember. Have the strength to remember and to deal with that memory. You know what I'm saying? It's not going to kill you. You know what I'm saying? Especially if you're on that road, on that path of healing. It's not going to kill you. Actually, it makes you a stronger person. For real, for real. It really does. Okay. In ways we don't have to understand, His Holy Spirit burrows down to the root of the problem and does what Jesus did during His earthly walk and promised by His command to heal. And that's in the book of Matthew, chapter 10, verses 1 and verses 8. I gather done, y'all. This was a really, really, really good read for me. And I hope it was a really, really good read for you. And again, I couldn't find that book that I used to have. But when I was on Amazon, I seen quite a few books about healing. I'm like, you know, people, I cannot think of that book out here. But it was a good book and everything. And so, and there's a lot of books out there about healing. Because that's my prayer over this summer. While I'm not making videos, I'm going to put this prayer out right now to cover this. Cover your whole summer for healing. Let the process begin. And if it have begun, the prayer is to see it through. Persevere so you can be completely healed from the things, from the wounds, from the hurts, from the pain. You know what I'm saying? And so you can live the life that God has for you to live and everything. You know, I say best life because that's what God wants us to do. You know, God gave us a gift of life. He said, yeah, it's going to be troubles and stuff. But if you keep your mind stayed on God, you keep your mind stayed on Jesus, He said, you shall live in perfect peace and everything. So it's steps. It's a process to get there, but you can get there. Now, me, I'm not 100, and I probably won't never be 100 to the day I leave this earth. But I'm a long, long, long way from where I used to be. And pain, yeah, I feel pain. You know, I'm human and everything, but I know how to deal with it. I know when I start feeling it, I know how not to let it depress me. Or go into that other utter darkness place and everything. I know how to say the prayer. And I ask God to let the process of healing to begin in that situation. Because look, I don't have time for that. I'm 52. I don't raise like majority of my kids. I ain't finna just sit like be through raising kids and just let all that take the rest of my life. And no. I'm not going out like that. You get what I'm saying? You know, people like when they finish raising kids, they have goals and dreams and everything. Mass not to travel, but if that happens, cool. Mass is just to live the life God has for me in my latter years. You know what I'm saying? Whatever that may whatever that latter is. You know, whatever comes. You know, because I know trials and tribulations is still going to come. But I want to be able to, like, I got this. You know? And really have, you know, I'm not saying I got it and still feeling some type of way about it. I want to really say I got this and be able to enjoy my life from, right now I'm still raising kids and stuff. You know, I still got, well, George is still here, but he doing his thing. He going to school and stuff. I still got Rain and Shane, you know, they're going to be 16 to 17. So it's still that. I'm still in that place and everything, but I won't always be in this place. And I don't want, when I'm not in this place of raising kids and everything, that I'm in a place of still feeling depressed about things, holding on to things and everything. And me and my hubby can't enjoy our life from wherever we at forward. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to be that woman. You know, I can't smile. You know, I can't be in the moment and everything. Like, man, we could have just kept raising kids forever then. And we just going to be like, you know, about life. Because teenagers have you like, you know. No. So, yeah. I'm like, whatever God brings to the surface, to the forefront, I'm going to deal with mass. You know. And, yeah, if I'm going to feel all kind of emotions. I might cry, I might, you know, be angry, get mad and all that, but hey, that's part of the process. But I'm gonna be free of that, of those things. You hear me? So, and I want y'all to be too and everything, because hey, why not? Who wants to live their life like that? Why? When it's another way to live. I can see if this was it. No, this is not it, because I am living it. I am living like, stuff don't stress me out like that, y'all. I don't get anxiety about things. Because I got this understanding like, hey, life happens. But it's how you deal with it. And now I think I have like some techniques I use, some strategies that I use to deal with things. You know? And I can smile. I can really be happy, and I have joy down on the inside of my heart, you know, regardless of all this stuff that's going happening around me and everything. No, not sharing. And if I cross people paths like that, hey, that silent prayer thing, there it is. I'm gonna send up a prayer for you, but no. It ain't no misery, love, no company, because I'm not miserable, and I don't want that type of company in my presence. You know what I'm saying? Birds of a feather flock together. I will flock by myself, me and my hubby. I'm good. You get what I'm saying? And I want you to be good, too, and everything. So let the healing begin. So, y'all, I got her done and everything, and I hope the read and my input, like, take y'all through y'all summer and everything. I'ma really miss doing my reads and miss talking to you all and everything, but I'm tired. You know, I'm like physical tired, and then like I say, these reads take a lot out of me emotionally, mentally, because I have to go places and bring up things that come up, and I'm not scared to talk about these things, you know what I'm saying, because it might help somebody else, you know. And I don't think we go through things just for us. We go through things for other people, to help other people. And so, yeah, but with doing all that, it's just got me kind of just like weak in my spirit, weak in my flesh, just weak. And so I need to regroup. I need a rejuvenation going on in my life right now. And I hope you all enjoy y'all summer, because you know, before it's over with, for us that have like experience all four seasons, you know, it's gonna be cold again and everything. But enjoy with your loved ones, don't let nobody stress you out, and whatever feelings that's making you feel depressed or experience anxiety and all that, pray about it, ask God to heal you, talk about it, see a therapist, get it out for real, because it's like a cancer. Even when you got cancer, they go up and then try to remove different parts of the cancer out, because other than that, it could just take over your whole body. That's what hurts, wounds, and pains do, and come from the memories, you know. So get that stuff out of you, detox your life. This gonna be a detox in summer, okay. So on that note, y'all, and it's kind of sad for me, because I feel it, you know, I'm really committed to what I do, and yeah, but it's necessary. But I still be watching vlogs, so yeah, that's easy to do. I could like just watch somebody else like and get what I'm gonna get from that and just keep it moving. And so yeah, and on that note, I'm out, and I hope everybody have a blessed summer. I ain't gonna even say the day, just a summer, a safe summer, a productive summer, because we got things. I have a list to do over the summer. I gotta wash the curtains, I gotta redo them basement steps, I gotta go through my drawers and reorganize my drawers, I gotta go through the stuff that's on my bookcase and those bins and clean that out. So I done made myself a list of things to do over the summer as well, that I just been too tired to really get to, because it's kind of tedious and everything. So yeah, so have a productive summer, whatever it may be, get her done, you know what I'm saying, and have a protective summer. Be safe out here, people, you know, because I want everybody to come back in September, you know, whole, healthy, on your way to, and all the goodness, you know, and everything. And even if we lose some people over the summer, because things happen in the summertime, it's okay. It's life. Life happened to us all. It's okay to feel sad, to grieve, to mourn. Keep the memory, but live your life. Enjoy your life. Okay? Enjoy your song. And on that note, I'm out. Peace, love, share song. And what? I holla. See you in September. All right. Bye, y'all.